Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of Beyond the Mask. In today's episode I want to discuss a specific character from the Scream franchise, but more importantly I want to discuss what kind of role they're going to have in Scream 6. So the character I want to discuss today is Gale Weathers. Now, Courtney Cox has said herself that she is signing on to Scream 6, but nothing has been officially confirmed. I don't know if there's negotiations going on there or if they're keeping some elements of a appearance a surprise, or production so far for Scream 6 has been a little wacky to say the least. It's all over the place, but the character of Gale Weathers is someone that is rumoured to be a main target slash focus in this movie. So what I want to do is, with this video, I want to explain to some of you why Gale Weathers being the main focus of this next movie makes perfect sense, because Gale's someone who's been up against every single ghost face and survived so far, but there was one key element that she had that kept her alive in these movies. So let's get into this video. So firstly, let me just say that Gale's a very important character in Scream, more important than people tend to give her credit for. Not only was she one of the only characters to sort of survive every attack alongside Sydney, throughout the whole movies, Gale was always underestimated. In Scream 1, Billy and Stu completely underestimated her involvement in this story. Mrs. Loomis seemed to acknowledge how much of a force Gale could be, but her own feud with Gale sort of got in the way and she did want Gale dead, but she didn't manage to pull it off because Gale is very good at surviving. Gale's purpose in Scream 3 was pretty important as well. Even though she may not have been a direct target, she definitely played a huge part in exposing majority of what Roman Bridger was trying to tell Sydney in Scream 3. The whole aspect of Rena Reynolds slash Maureen Prescott being involved with John Milton was sort of laid there for the detectives to find out. It ended up being Gale that solved this more than they did. Even though she had a couple of helpful tips along the way, the purpose of Gale being there and her involvement was to expose this story. Then in Scream 4 and 5, Gale was only used as collateral to get to Sydney, so she was attacked because of that reason. Jill seemed to actually not want Gale to die. It's something that's often overlooked about that character. She made an off comment to Dewey about her and Gale writing this new book with matching wounds. I think that that's something that she wanted. She wanted to be immortalized through a book, and Gale was the one to do it. And I believe that in Scream 5 with Richie and Amber, I don't think they ever actually targeted Gale, but I do believe that they had the intentions of potentially keeping her alive in the hopes that she would go on to write a book about them. What does this mean for Scream 6? Well, for the first time ever, we're getting Gale sort of at the forefront of the story. She's going to be someone that's going to be main target for once, and it makes perfect sense. And here's why. Because at the end of 5, Gale told Sydney and told Sam that she wasn't writing any more books. And even Sydney makes that point of saying, no more books, no more movies, no more Ghostface. And because she says that very statement, Gale's purpose is no longer relevant. Because the killers tend to use her and keep her sort of there, because they want her to make a book. They want her to make a story out of their stories or their killings. So now she's not doing that, it changes everything. Gale's no longer got that purpose anymore. She's someone who's just there for the sake of it. And so I think that's one of the reasons why we're going to be seeing a Gale-centric story in this next movie. It's also one of the reasons why I believe this character has never had a phone call properly. She was meant to in Scream 2, and that was Mrs. Loomis that wanted to do that. She wanted Gale dead. She's the only person who specifically wanted her dead. And so I think that now we're going to be getting more of that, and this is the perfect way for Gale to go, because now there's nothing to keep her alive. There's no reason for her to be kept there for the purpose of book writing. This character is going to really evolve in this next movie over everybody else. That's what people seem to be forgetting. This character is going to really come into her own in this next movie, I believe. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video, that lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Closing off this video, I want to leave it on a Gale Weathers quote.
Hang on. Are you familiar with the phrase, I wrote the book on this?
You like scary?